I've been coding for about 7 years now, and it's been a huge part of my life. It started in 2015 when I chose computer science as my major, then graduating with a CS degree and getting my first full-time job in Manhattan as a software engineer, to moving to Los Angeles in 2020 for a new job, a completely remote developer position, and after working in that job for 1 year, fast forward to August of 2021, quitting my job to pursue self-employment and freelance. This won't be a normal day in the life because I'm no longer a software engineer for a big company, but I'm almost 25 years old, worked full-time in the industry for 2.5 years, and my normal routine still consists of 40 hours a week of coding. My name is Jed, I'm a YouTuber, a recent startup founder, and a programming freelancer. Welcome to a day in my life. So my day starts waking up usually at around 10 a.m., and the first hour of my day is spent on my laptop, replying to emails. I'm really particular about this, but I hate the idea of staying home and spending the entire workday on my desk, but this preference really only began after having a remote job for a year during COVID lockdown. So after about an hour or two of coding, I'll pack up my things and head out for lunch. And since I'm self-employed with a flexible schedule, I love bouncing around LA and trying out different coffee shops every day. I was a full-time software engineer in the front-end team for about 2.5 years, and just last August of 2021, I quit my full-time coding job to pursue self-employment, to pursue YouTube. At the time, I only had 77,000 subscribers, which is not a lot when it comes to full-time YouTube as a career. And there were some people saying, wouldn't you rather have a high-paying software engineer job for a tech company? And the way I see it is, yeah, that's true, but wouldn't you take a pay cut to work your dream job? So aside from doing YouTube full-time, my day-to-day coding breakdown is something like 70% coding right in my dorm, my startup, and 30% coding for this freelance project that I've been working ever since, I would say, August. I don't usually take on too many freelance coding gigs, but for the past few months, I've been an independent contractor building a web app for a part of the government. So today's Wednesday, and I told the guy everything would be done by tomorrow. So here at the coffee shop, I've been trying to finish everything in time for our check-in call. And I would say I would spend about 2-3 hours a day for the past few months. Back in August is when I got this gig. And August is also the time I quit my full-time job. This gig was a huge reason on why I was comfortable taking the leap. I knew that this was about a year-long contract, so I knew that there was that sense of stable income. But this is one of the reasons why I'm glad I took computer science in college. Coding is such a marketable skill, not only in a full-time job, but also as a freelancer. After a few hours of coding in the coffee shop, I made some plans to meet up with friends. Something you have to be mindful of out of college, as a working adult in your 20s, is that all of your friends are in their own schedule, in their own routine, and if you don't go out of your way to make plans to hang out, you probably would hardly see them. So after work, my normal routine is usually to go to the gym, but today we decided to play some ping pong.
Both of your legs gone away, you falling for me. The same way that the rain falls. I ain't gon' lie, you got it all. The girl in my dream, I ain't falling asleep.
So it's 11 o'clock right now, and earlier today I put in about 2 hours of work on my freelance project. Before going to bed, I feel like I need to put in at least 4 hours of coding for me to go to bed accomplished. It's pretty late, but I think this is pretty normal for me to be productive at night. What I'm gonna work on right now is Rate My Dorm, which is my startup. I've been documenting it on this channel, but if you're new here, I did an official launch of my dorm review website, and that was just a couple of days ago. Since I am the only developer on the team, there's a lot of work to do, a lot of maintenance to get done, and I'm gonna work on some specific tasks today. I'm probably gonna sleep at around 2 a.m. tonight, which is pretty average. All right, just a quick demo on what it's like being an admin. Here's one pending review, and I just do a quick read to see if it's, you know, not obscene. I can see that this is UC Riverside, so they are gonna be a verified student, which is why they have a badge there. That looks good. So when it's approved, that means it's gone on the website. Here's something that's pretty cool. For the people that do add photos, I added a way to assign it to the banner. So if you go on the school right now, it just has the default banner. But if I see something here that I like, I'm gonna click this, set as door banner. There we go, it turns into the banner. I am the only developer, and it's kind of just up to me to come up with what tasks I want, what features to add. And today, my task on the list is coding an easier way to approve and add a new school to the platform. So right now, I can see that someone wants to review this house. And what I do here is I add a new school. So that looks good. Press submit review. And it added the dorm, the school, and the review all at once. And I think that was pretty easy, so you can see on the site, anyone who goes to this dorm can now write a review because I approved the review. If I were to give you a breakdown of my income, I would say it's been about 70% social media / YouTube. 30% of that is the freelance project, and Rate My Dorm is currently 0%. Of course, my hope, as any startup founder would feel, is this has the most potential out of everything, which is why I devote so many hours a week on this project. So it's almost midnight now, and I'm gonna spend the rest of the day coding up some new features on Rate My Dorm because this is now my full-time job. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I actually leave for Guam on Sunday, so this is my last 3 days here in LA, which is kind of sad. I'm gonna be packing all this stuff up soon. So for the next 2 videos or so, be prepared for an entirely change of scenery, unlike anything you've seen in my past many videos. And I'm excited. I'll see you guys soon.